Hello. Nomads Cult, Ribbons, or in German, Bänder. Okay, let's go to the Nomads Cult app. Yes, I do this video a second time because it, yes. Okay, let's start. First, the easiest way to create such ribbons is to use the selection mask. Let's validate this cube and subdivide it a few times. And we use a front view, or use always a direct view, and use the selection mask and turn off the symmetry and use the rectangular selection. And now you can use this to yes and check always that front vertex only or such things are turned off or on. And now when you got this, go to the settings of the selection mask, and the shell thickness here is 0.2, and now you can extract this shell. Now you got this, and you can paint it with this material, for example. Paint all, turn off the wireframe, and now you got this nice ribbons. Okay, and you can do this with every mesh. Here is a sphere. I validate it, and I'm dragging it a little bit. Yes, create an object, and now bring the object in the right view for using the selection mask, because it works only in a 90 degree angle. Now you can select this one. The mesh is real. I remesh it to make it clearer. And now you can bring here the mask, and you can do it for clothes or such things, and use the selection mask, same setting as before, and extract it. And in the solo view, you see you got this belt, or guess. And the higher the mesh is, the clearer is the object. Okay, but let's do another thing. Go to the front view, and we use a tube tool, and we use a curve. And you can draw every shape you want. But make it, close it always in the front view. Okay, let's do such a thing and close this object, and go to the topology and reduce the division to 4. Let's turn on the wireframe, and I think this is okay. Sometimes the tube is a little bit rotated. Use the front view for this. And when you're fine, you can adjust your radius of the tube. And now turn on the gizmo, and you can use the blue ball to scale it to make it like a band or a ribbon. Yes, you can adjust now the radius or how thick it is. And okay. And the next thing is you can go to the gizmo settings and move it to the origin. And now you can turn on the mirror function at the top and use the turn off the planes and you use the radial symmetry on the Y. And now you can bring your objects here in the room. And you can make it, you can adjust it like you want. And you can add more radius points. You can make it for every position the radius, but you can test it for your own. And when you're fine with this, you can validate the object. And now this object is one object and you can use the drag brush, for example, make it real big and sorry, let's test the move brush. Is there connected topology? Yes, now it works. Symmetry is on, connected topology, and now you can adjust your ribbons like you want. And when you're fine, you can use topology settings. You can use a flat subdivision one time, one or two times, and you can make now with a turn off the flat subdivision, and now you when you subdivide it, it was one time too much. Now flat subdivision is off and subdivide it again. Now the edges are a little bit smoother like this. You can test it with a subdivision. And when you're fine, give the whole thing a color and turn the wireframe off. That's it. Okay, have fun with sculpting. Ciao.